Hello, my name is Youjin Lee, and thank you so much for joining today's my graduation recital. It's a great pleasure for me to be able to share this wonderful music with you today. Before I introduce my recital program, I want to express my appreciation toward the school, faculty, and staff members at Curtis, including my beloved teachers, Ms. Kavafian and Ms. Frank, and my colleagues as well. 5 years at Curtis has been most memorable and meaningful time for me, and I'm looking forward to my next journey. To open up my recital today, I'll begin with music by Mozart Sonata, K454 in B-flat major. This is one of his latest sonatas, and this particular sonata has such a grand and monumental achievement. Interestingly, Mozart named it as sonatas for piano and violin instead of violin and piano. And personally, I thought the conversation between the pianist and violinist is one of the crucial roles in this music. Especially a time like this, during the pandemic year, I've been missing playing chamber music so much with my friends at school. But luckily, I was able to share the stage with lovely pianist Soyoo Hong, and I hope you'll enjoy our musical conversation. Thank you. Hope you'll enjoy.
Bye. Thank you. Thank you.
So the next piece you'll hear is Paganini Caprice No. 24, which has one of the famous tunes, and you'll notice immediately after you hear it, which is... so on. Based on this simple tune, Paganini twists it around with various techniques that violinists can express with their hands. Such as there's a variation for left hand pizzicato, which you plug the string and make a sound on it. And there is a variation for thirds and tenths, which requires stretch for our fingers, and so on. But each variation has their own beauty, and hope you can hear this beautiful music. Thank you.
Thank you.
Hindemith Sonata for Violin and Piano, Opus 11, No. 1, was written in 1918 during the World War I. It has two movements. The first movement, it starts with such a fresh and energetic character, but then throughout the piece, it has really cool and singing melodies in the middle section. But at the end, back again to the first motifs, which is energetic and fresh. The second movement is a solemn dance, and it has dark and heavy atmosphere in it. And one can make a relationship between the atmosphere during the war time and his uses of the dissonant harmony and brutal harmonies. So, yeah, hope you can enjoy. Thank you. Thank you. Eugène Ysaÿe was a Belgian composer and a violinist, and he wrote 6 sonatas for solo violin. And each one of them was dedicated to the composers and the violinist who he really admired. And this sonata number 3, the Ballade, was dedicated to the Romanian composer George Enescu. This sonata number 3 has such poetic and rhapsodic elements in the composition. And I personally think that some piece takes time to really understand the meaning of it and takes time to acquire the taste. And I think this is one of them. But I sincerely love to play this music, and I hope you enjoy it. Thank you. The last piece I'll play for you is the Wieniawski Polonaise, which is such a fun and jubilant and energetic piece to end up. And without any further explanation, I want you to enjoy it. And thank you for staying until the end. Thank you.